Konnichiwa! Welcome everybody back to Chrono Reviews. This time I'm actually gonna review a Predator, which is nothing less than NECA's Tracker Predator from Predators. Well, it was a little bit late for me to get this now, because I've been out for quite some time, so I'm quite surprised I haven't ordered this earlier. However, now I finally have it, so let's check out the package. It is the same style as the others, with the Predator's text here, clear plastic casing so you can see the figure. On the back there is the others from the series, and this is series 2, which includes the masked battle damaged version of Classic and the unmasked Berserker. So here's some information about Tracker, a nice picture and artwork like here. So well, let's open this up and check it out. Alright, here is Tracker Predator from Predators. And I must say, the sculpture on this figure is very good and accurate, just like expected from NECA. And the paint job is good enough. There is a lot of complaints on the paint jobs on those, however I find them good enough. Sure, they could be a little bit better, but nothing that bothers me. However, the tusks was broken in the package, but both tusks was actually in the package, actually, so nothing I can't fix. However, it's a little bit annoying that it happens anyhow. And well, let's check out the figure except for that now. The paint job and details are good. I like the glossy shiny on the eyes. Right, and the articulation of this figure. Well, first off, this is a little bit loose. You can detach the blade, so I'm removing this for now because it's loose. Well, the articulation is, the head is on a ball joint. However, a little bit limited, but it's there. The shoulder cannon can swivel side to side, up and down. This also pops off easily. However, it is easy to put back again. The arms are on ball jointed. And here you can swivel, and there's a joint, elbow joint, but this is stuck with paint on both arms actually. Just like with my Falconer, so I have to get out a solution for that. Hands are on ball joints and they work perfectly. The torso can turn. The legs are on cut joints like this and like this. Just like with the first two and the Classic Predator. And there are a knee joint. And the feet on the Super Preds, which have those kind of boots, are just swivel joints like this. So there you have the articulation for Tracker Predator. It works. And I'm very excited for NECA's new double knee joints that I invented for the Predator 2 series that will come out. Now, accessories, there are none. Just like with the other two. But there are not that much extra for those Preds in this movie. No extra weapons and stuff, however Falconer lacked his Falcon. Except for that, a little bit, a trophy or something, or a spine or anything could have been nice to have, yes. Or a nice base from the Predator camp or something. Well, but I like this figure, and I'm glad to finally have it, except that I need to fix the tusks. So let's compare him to the other two. So here we have them. The Predators, Super Predator trio. A nice looking little hunting party. So well. One last check on the Tracker Predator. And they have really improved how they make accurate sculptures on these figures. And how they sculpt almost all the dreads separately like this. It's just amazing how they improve the figures over the years. So I hope you enjoyed this. Maybe you decided on getting a tracker predator. However, when it comes to the quality part, there is sometimes better to find those figures in store or in a convention or something, so you can actually look into the package and see that, yeah, everything is intact. However, I ordered this for a good price, so I can't complain. So I'll see you next time, and sayonara, take care.